Hey guys, welcome to the Rough Cuts Wednesday. I'm CaliCritic, and I'm going to do something different today because I'm a little bit of a time constraint right now. But I'm going to do a quick review of my favorite television show of all time, which had just got renewed for one final season, even though it's in its fourth season right now. But there will only be one more season, 16 episodes, which kind of dismays me because it's such a great show. And that is AMC's Breaking Bad. The show is created by Vince Gilligan, who is a longtime writer for The X-Files, and it stars Bryan Cranston as Walter White, an everyman who has recently just turned 50. He's a high school chemistry teacher in Albuquerque, New Mexico. He has a loving wife, Skylar, played by Anna Gunn, and he also has a son, Walter Jr., played by RJ Mitt. And he also has a brother-in-law named Hank, who's played by Dean Norris, who's a DEA agent, too. And what happens is that he gets diagnosed with stage 3 terminal lung cancer, and he figures out that the payments that he has in his family is not enough to cover all the stuff that he's going to have to pay for his chemotherapy treatment and everything, but he also wants to leave behind a fortune for his family, knowing that he's going to die at some point. So he teams up with an old student of his who failed his class named Jesse Pinkman, played by Aaron Paul, and they both team up to cook crystal meth and sell it on the streets so he can have a fortune to pay for his family in the future. Now, this TV show is my favorite of all time, mostly because of how original the concept is. When you hear a show about a high school teacher who decides to break bad and become a meth cooker, that really hits you. But the way in which the style is done within the very clever writing and the outstanding directing, it is a perfect combination of drama and very great dark comedy at the same time. Bryan Cranston has won 3 Emmys in a row for this show, and he's not nominated this year because the fourth season premiered late, but he is fantastic in this show. It is a massive transition from playing a childish father and Malcolm in the Middle to come into this show and be one of the most badass meth cookers you will ever see on TV. You simply do not want to mess with this guy, because the more that he gets affected by his cancer, the more you do not want to have any misstep with him, because he will mess you up in one way or the other. But of the whole cast, a real standout in the supporting category is definitely Aaron Paul, who plays his partner in crime, Jesse Pinkman. His character is such a screw-up because he causes more than half the problems that these two get into in the show, but it's the way that Paul just plays the character as this real screw-up. He delivers the comedy scene so well, especially a scene which involves the word robot. And if you've heard of the show, you'll know what I'm talking about, because it's one of the funniest scenes in the show. The villains that they have in the show are also great, like Tuco in season 1 and 2, played by Raymond Cruz, is one of the most evil guys you will see, especially insane for how he gets. But Gus Fring, who's played by Giancarlo Esposito, is even more scary because he has a very quiet and shady personality of how he runs his business. But when stuff goes wrong, he turns into a very silent, lethal machine in which you simply know, I cannot mess with this guy. As I said, the directing and writing is superb in about every episode of this show, but the show is also shot beautifully. It has a handheld style throughout the first 3 seasons, and it has these time-lapse shots that are just perfect. If you want to get a good dosage of both dark comedy, drama, and some hard-hitting action at times, you definitely should check out Breaking Bad. It has phenomenal acting, and the twists and turns that come from each way, from all the characters and the events that they go through, is great. Definitely check out Breaking Bad if you get the time. I'm one of the biggest fans of the show, so definitely start watching the show as soon as you can. So I thank you all for watching, and stay tuned for yet another. So I thank you all for watching, and stay tuned next Wednesday for yet another review by me. Thanks for watching.